Hey, what's up everyone, and welcome to a brand new Let's Play, day one of a game that you can actually see on the screen right there, Mario Kart 8. I've got it right here in my hands now, in the box. It's still in the Nintendo seal wrapper thing, so I'm gonna go ahead and open this up, if I can actually do that. It's cellophane wrapped, there we go. Pop that with a pencil. I decided I'd go ahead and actually open the game in the recording for you guys, because I have been so ridiculously hyped for this game, and you would get to see it showing up on screen at the same time I do. I'm just gonna switch that over right there so you can see. Sorry if I sounded like I went away from the microphone there. It's because I did. And wait, there we go. Because, well, I'll explain why in a little moment. I'm just gonna go ahead and walk over to my Wii U and put this game in. The disc looks amazing. It's got Mario on it, in his car, and anti-gravity. Let's put this thing in. Alright, the disc is in. Just wait for it to boot that. And as you can see, yeah, I can't get on the internet right now, so I won't be able to post anything to Miiverse. There is good old Mario. How's it going, buddy? Let's get this started. Ah! I'm gonna be using my Wii U Pro controller for this, and the reason I actually stepped away from the mic to touch the gamepad to switch the screens over. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Ah. Is because, Listen to the music. I am dancing in my chair right now. Ah. Yeah, there's no gamepad capture device as of recording this. So what am I going to be doing? I'm going to be using my camera to try and capture the gamepad to film the map, because that appears on the bottom screen. I might not even end up using that, so if you don't see it, I'm not using it, because it might look like garbage, but just so you know, I'm going to be trying to do that. And it looks like we start off with 28 stamps unlocked. Oh, it's going to be trying to prepare Miiverse, and I can't even get on the internet right now. You know, you could just show me the stamps, you're just going to come up with an error code. I'm just saying. Come on. It's just gonna be an error code. You're just gonna come up with an error code. My camera just turned itself off. That's how long you've been trying to do this. It's a wonderful start, isn't it? Really, game? Okay, there we go. There's the error code. Alright, so I guess let's get started with single player. I'm going to be going through everything, so, well, we're going to be starting Grand Prix here. And I'm going to be doing 50, 100, 150, and I'm assuming there's a mirror mode, so we'll be doing that as well. Let's get started here with, for episode 1, with 50cc. I'm going to be using Mario, because how can you not? But look at all these characters, though. Why is it not changing? There we go. They all look so good in HD. They're taking a little while to change, but okay. I guess it's because it's the first time I booted up the game, maybe. Yeah, look at all of these guys. Baby Mario. Baby Weege, Babel Peach, Babel Daisy. We've got Bowser over here. He looks awesome in this game. Look at that. Donkey Kong. We've got Wario and Waluigi. But I am actually going to be going in order with the characters, so we're going to be using Mario for this one. And, let's see. Now, some of these, yeah, see, that's called the Buggy Bud. I'm pretty sure in America this is called the Biddy Bud or something like that. Because this is a PAL version of the game, some of the names will be different. Let's see. Honestly, let's just go standard everything to start this off. Super Glider, yeah, let's do that. And alright, Mushroom Cup, Mario Kart Stadium, Water Park, Sweet Sweet Canyon, and Thwomp Ruins. Let's do this. I'm gonna start my camera right now. That loading screen, though. You can see all the ads and stuff in the background. It's awesome. Oh, I'm so ridiculously hyped. Whoa, that looks even better on my TV. Another thing about this game, it runs at 60 FPS. Frames per second, that is. But my Elgato can only record 30 FPS, plus YouTube doesn't support 60 frames per second. So we're just gonna have to have 30 on the LP, but it shouldn't be too bad. Oh, come on, let's get this boost. Yes, let's go! I am liking this already. Listen to that music. Let's go, Mario. Oh, this feels familiar already. I feel right at home with this. Now, another thing about this game, you can only hold one item, so I've got this green shell holding it behind me. I can't use another one. I can't have another item on me. Also, anti-gravity, yes! Eat this, Bowser, I missed. This anti-gravity already, I already like it. This is amazing. I'm loving this game already, and we're on the first course. This is quite the one to start with. Aha! And to say this is 50cc, this actually feels really fast. Well, let's do the glider. Yeah, gliding! Alright, let's go on here, do a trick. Sweet, let's go on the boost panels, why not? I'm gonna drop a banana right there. Oh, another trick? Yeah! Oh, that was awesome. I know I'm just kind of saying like, oh, this is awesome, oh my god. You guys may not know, I'm a huge Mario Kart fan. It's probably my second favorite series next to Smash Brothers. Also, I just got a freaking coin item. It's one of the ones they brought back for this game. I believe they were only ever really seen as an item in... what was it in now? It was in... What was it? Super Mario Kart, the original. Actually, I just realized that on the camera screen, it's showing the horn. I guess I should probably change that. Because you can see the map over at the right-hand side there, and I'm pretty sure you can, like, tap it or something to bring it up on the big screen, so... Maybe I should try do that. Yeah, I'll do it on this straight. Okay, let's try this. Map. Yeah, there we go, map. Oh, I fell. That's what we want. Okay. It's kind of annoying that it shows it on the gamepad and not on the TV. But honestly, I think I'll get used to it. I never really use it that much in other games anyway. I'll only really use it to have a look at how far behind people are, so... Yeah. Also, that'll look really awkward if I don't even end up using the little map screen in the LP. Because it'll just be like, oh, I'm gonna switch it over, yeah, yeah, and then there's nothing on the screen, so... I don't know, maybe I'll use it, maybe I won't. Depends how it looks in editing, to be honest. Also, if this LP ends up not coming out on May 30th, then my original statement saying it's day one will have been completely false, but there you go. Alright, end of the first race, yeah! Oh. Now, as you can see there, for example, Ludwig, Lemmy, and Larry, those are all characters we don't have unlocked yet. They actually show up in races even if you don't have them unlocked, which I think is actually kind of cool. I was considering viewing a highlight reel for these, but I don't think we really need to, because it's basically just a replay, a fancy replay. What's this plus thing, by the way? Stars? I don't know what that is. Alright, let's just go into the next race. Which is, I believe, Water Park. Is it Water Park? Yes, it is! Alright, I wonder what those star things were. Also, it's showing the map instantly now, which is pretty nice. So, in fact, because another thing about my camera, it only records for 10 minutes at a time for some reason, so I'm gonna have to keep stopping and starting every race, which I may forget to do sometimes. I mean, I know that none of these races are probably gonna be 10 minutes long, but it's just a precaution, so... There you go. Oh, water park. I am doing pretty bad to start off with, but it's okay, I will get better. Underwater section, yeah! Bringing these back from Mario Kart 7. Oh, this is so good! I've got the biggest grin on my face right now. You do not even know. Oh, this game is amazing. And I'm in 50cc. I never say 50cc is amazing. But this one is. So there you go. Let's drift around, get some coins. If you get 10 coins, as you may know, I'm just explaining this for anyone who may not know. Get 10 coins and your speed will go up to its maximum. So that's what that means. And also, I don't think... Are we gonna land on top? Are we gonna land on top? No, we're not. We can't even... Once you've gone down with the glider in this game, you can't really go back up again, which is odd, because you could in 7, so... And I'm trying to, like, trick off of those, but it wasn't working. One thing I really like about this game so far is... I actually really... Oh, well, that was a lone green shell. I really like how the characters hold their items, like they did in Double Dash, and I guess to an extent, you know, the arcade Grand Prix games. I just really like that, unless of course you hold in my case. I guess it's L. Is it L on the Pro Controller? I guess so. You press and hold that, and they drop it behind them, or they drag it behind them if you hold it. So I don't know. I like it. They kind of mix together the two styles. The only bad thing is you can only have one item, which is kind of, it's gonna take a bit of getting used to, I think. But I don't know. It should be pretty easy to get used to. No! Why can I not make it on top of there? Right, let's try some snaking. Alright, that's a bit of snaking going on there. There we go. Don't think you can trick off of there. But you can, start, what am I trying to say here? You can start a drift. If you get hit by something and you stop moving, you can start a drift really quickly. Like, you don't even have to be going that fast to start a drift. Also, that thing there I didn't really mention. If you bump into anything like that when you're in anti-gravity, you'll do a little spin like that, and you'll get a boost. And the same goes for other opponents. If they're in anti-gravity, and you are, and you hit into them, then, you'll both spin out, but you'll get a boost. That's kind of interesting how, well, more coins, I don't need any more. I'm pressing the item button now, and it's doing a horn. Which in itself is kind of like Double Dash as well, so it's pretty cool. Although in Double Dash it was more of a taunt, so yeah, that was pretty good. I liked that one. I liked Water Park. What are these, though? What are those? Alright, next course. I don't recall what this one is, actually. What is the next course? Oh yeah, Sweet Sweet Canyon. I seem to remember... No, I didn't mean to skip that! Aww, why did I do that? Sorry, guys. Instinct. I skipped it by accident, so there you go. Didn't mean to do that. But you'll see it in 100cc, 150 in mirror, so... That, of course, is assuming there is a mirror. I have not actually seen mirror mode in this game from any videos I've seen, so... Who knows if there's mirror, but there most likely is mirror mode. Why would mirror mode not make a return? Just saying. Drifting around this corner. Yeah! Underwater. Let's go the blue way to start off with. Can we trick? Yes! You can trick. And I'm just getting coin items right now. I would appreciate more than coins. Although I'm in first place, so I can't really expect to get anything more than coins, because first place. Oh yeah! See a trick right here? I'm pretty sure that... Oh, red shell, okay. When you do a trick, if you hold in a direction with a control stick, then you will do a different trick. Like, I held right there, and he did the trick towards the right, so... That's an interesting detail that they put in. Alright, because the trick is with the... I guess it's the R button, isn't it? No, it's the ZR button. And I looked at my controller and hit something on screen. Okay, don't look at your controllers, kids, when you're racing. The more you know. And I'm sorry if there is a tiny bit of an echo with the game audio, but I've got my TV on pretty loud right now. Also, did I get a mushroom in first place? Okay. I've got my TV on pretty loud right now because I want to hear all the sound effects and the music and everything, so... Yeah, this is my first-hand experience with this game. This is you guys seeing it for the first... Maybe it's you guys seeing it for the first time. I doubt it. But it's me playing it for the first time, and it's you witnessing it with me. So, there you go. All the coins. So, backflip. Yeah. Look at all the gingerbread men. I should have kept an item. That's the thing about being in first place now, because you can only have one item. You really want to keep it, so I'm going to do that from now on. I should have just kept my red shell that I had earlier, but then I got rid of that and got a mushroom. So. Really? I'm back to 5 coins? I want to get 10 coins, because coins are how you unlock stuff in this game. You get, like, for each number of coins you get, like, maybe be it like 10, 20, whatever. Also, first blue. It's ugly, but the water apparently washes it off, okay. And I missed the item box. Yeah, for each, like, set of coins that you get, like, 10 or whatever, I'm pretty sure you can unlock stuff, so, yeah. I'm pretty sure you can actually unlock, all the characters before you get to 150cc, which will be pretty nice, to be honest, because they're unlocked just by beating Grand Prix, and they're unlocked at random. So once we beat this, once we beat this Grand Prix, assuming we win, which I doubt that we won't at this point, we will get, a character, and it'll be a random character. So, that's a pretty cool detail. Alright. Larry, I feel for you, Larry. You are in last place. And I want to know what those stars do. Alright, Thwomp Ruins. Wow, the Thwomps look really good. Not gonna lie.
Ah, Thwomp Ruins!
This is one of the courses I'm actually looking forward to quite a bit, just because of all... There's one section where there's a whole bunch of different routes you can take, and I don't know, I'm just intrigued. Boop! Oh, that was kind of a crappy boost, but okay. There's a shortcut off there to the left, actually, I just noticed, so that's the thing. Go around these corners quite sharp. Oh, actually, no, I want to get some coins on this first lap. Because, coins. Ooh, let's go into the anti-grav. Anti-grav! Whoa, that's going to take a bit of getting used to, I think. Like, the angle... Well, not even the camera angle change, because that... It doesn't really change. It's just Mario kind of change there. It's just when going onto the wall, it's going to take a bit of getting used to, because the controls kind of change a tiny bit. But not too much, so it shouldn't be too bad. This music, though... kind of cool. The music in this game, I'm pretty sure almost all of it was recorded live, so that's pretty good. No, like I do, lift me up, and I kept my item. That is a cool feature. You keep your item if you fall off. Now, whoa, someone took that shortcut. That was kind of awkward, actually. No, and the gliders are kind of different in this game as well. They're not, you can't move as much as with them as you can in Mario Kart 7, so that's interesting. Coin! Horn. Okay, let's go down the middle this time. Oh, whoa. This route, that's what I meant to say. I'm guessing they kind of encourage you to go on the wall because there's all those boost panels. Also, we can totally go up this middle bit this time. Gliding! See, as you can see, you can go in the water, you can go off to the left or right, and you can go either up or not up the anti-grav section that I went up on the first lap. It's just so cool. This course has so much variety. And also, look, headlamps. The carts have headlamps, and you can see in caves with them. It's so awesome, all these little details. And I'm gonna try and do this time. Let's go! That kinda worked, okay. Yeah! Alright, let's land. Oh, no! That's gonna get some getting used to as well. The gliders are kind of got some odd controls in this game. Stop giving me so many coins! I have enough. And I don't actually know if they count towards your total at the end for unlocking stuff, so... I don't know, that'd be kind of interesting if they do, because... Also, yeah, they definitely want you to go that way, because it's so much quicker. Whoa! That could have been bad. I'm gonna go underwater. Go underwater. Whoa! The glider was still kind of there when I was underwater. Okay. Actually, if you don't put... Blue shell! First one! There it is! Boom. Didn't have a super horn to avoid that. For those of you who don't know what the super horn is, it's a new item introduced in this game. Really, that green shell hit me? Oh, well, I'm miles ahead. Item introduced in this game, which can destroy the blue shell, so that's a thing. I'm gonna go around here, because I want to get my 10 coins. I got 9 coins, no! Alright, let's see, can I get one off of this end bit here? Come on. No! Why is that so awkward to control? He just flies all over the place, and I almost hit my own banana there. Oh well. And with that, we've completed our first Grand Prix! You know what, let's do this, and see what happens. I don't know what's gonna happen. I don't know what that star thing means. So, that's a thing. If anyone knows what that means, let me know. These loading screens, though, they're really cool. And that is beautiful. Alright, it's going to show us a bit of a highlight reel. Well, some footage from Thwomp Ruins, apparently. Not much of a highlight reel. Oh, I thought it was going to include my unsuccessful attempt there. And first in every single one! Yeah! Now, I don't know if I'm going to get triple star rank. I hope I do. Let's find out. Triple star, come on. Yes, triple star! You unlocked the flower cup. And you unlocked a new character! No, I don't want to post a Miiverse because I can't right now because I don't have internet access. There we go. Triple star on the first Grand Prix. That made me happy. First time playing, I'm gonna go to triple star rank. Oh, that's awesome. Now let's see who we got, shall we? Let's see what character we unlocked. Oh, who is it? I believe, yep, Toadette! But we're not going to be using her for quite some time, actually. We're going to be using Luigi next time, because he's next in the rows. I'll tell you the order right now. Why not? Mario, Luigi, Peach, Daisy, and then we're going to go back to Yoshi, Toad, Koopa, Shy Guy, then Baby Mario, Baby Luigi, Baby Peach, and Baby Daisy, then Bowser, DK, Wario, Waluigi. And then we'll go into the unlockable characters, which we should have by the time we've used all these ones. So then we'll probably just go with this, and then I believe down there and across. So there you go. Next time on Mario Kart 8, we will be using Luigi. I don't know what kart we'll be using, or bike, because bikes are in this game, and the quad or ATVs. But that's what's going to be going on next time. So thank you all for watching this episode of my first episode of Mario Kart 8. So hype. Once I've completed some of this, and once I have internet access, I will do online races, I will do so much content with this game. I'm going to do all the Grand Prix, all the time trials, I'm going to show off versus and battle mode probably, and then I'm going to do online, there's going to be a whole effing show, it's going to be amazing. So thank you all once again for watching, leave a like if you enjoyed this episode, and subscribe if you're new to my videos, it really helps me out a ton, and I will catch you guys for the next episode of Mario Kart 8. See you guys then.